People. Que pasa, sapa, say what they do. Now the first thing that is popping in the news, people call it, say it isn't so, because based on some information that I just got, a news article from Nationwide News Network, it is said that the tool that was taken from Tommy Lee Sparta's waist, they ran some sort of ballistic test, and people remember, they said that it was linked to at least 3 slap away and some sort of shooting. Sorry, 2 slap away and also 3 sorts of shooting. Now people, based on the information that I have, it is said that these high profile persons, we are speaking about Father Fowle, and we are also speaking about Mr. Clark Alfonso, one British people. This is very disturbing news. If you're a Tommy Lee Sparta fan, because people like them say, trouble dead, point blank and period. Now people, what is very startling about this Tommy Lee Sparta case is that Tommy Lee Sparta has been held on several occasions. Every occasion him beat it. However, people, like the saying goes, every day the bucket goes to the well, one day the bottom is going to drop out. And people, it seems as if the bottom of the bucket drop out for Tommy Lee Sparta. However, it got worse this week when there was some sort of news that there were at least 2 bodies on the gun and also 3 shooting. However, people, it seems as if the whole well, everything mash up, all of the water spill. We're talking about the worst of the worst. We're talking about them fling all sort of monkey wrench in a Tommy Lee Sparta program. Because people, if this is true, and if this is not any sort of fake news, people, something is definitely fishy about this thing. And like me say, I am not saying that the popo are lying. However, people, if we should write a script, it would not play out like this. People, this is very sad. This is very disturbing. This is very confusing. This is very startling, point blank and period. So anyways, people, the moral of the story is that I have not confirmed. I am not 100% sure. However, if this is true, it is going to be problematic for Tommy Lee Sparta and his lawyer. Because, people, we are speaking about Wani British and Rifle. We are speaking about high profile, point blank and period. So anyways, people, let me know what you think in the comment section. Do you think that something is fishy about this news? Or do you think that Tommy Lee Sparta actually knows what went down as it pertains to Rifle? And also, may I talk about Mr. British? We are talking about the 2 British people. Let me know what you think in the comment section. So anyways, people, that is my views on the whole thing as it pertains to that. And like me say, it is just my views and opinion. It is not the gospel. Your views and opinion can be respectfully different from mine. But let me know what you think in the comment section. Bless up. Now people, the first thing that is popping in the news, when you hear me say on several occasions, many occasions, that Jamaica have the dunces criminals, the most laziest, if that is a word, the most boneheaded, them mad, them sick, them bad, them head no good, them dunks, them fool, they are everything that is bad. And people, in this voice note that I am going to let you listen to, it is a perfect example. I am speaking about a lady, hardworking young lady, that dropped off her car to some sort of mechanic off Lindhurst Road, I think. And then when the mechanic bring back the car and she was dropping off the mechanic, there was some young men on the road and some sort of yeng, a chill out, a wait upon their next unsuspecting victim. And people, because of the fact that she was driving some sort of Prada, they decided that she would be their next victim. However, people, what they said to her and what transpired between this lady and these thief, you are going to be very surprised. You are going to be shocked. You are going to be awed. So people, take a listen, take a look, and then I'll give my piece.
Yo, me do you want to give the man them a drama star? Bumbuckle, I tell you, say, yo, them youth there Jamaica, the man them suck completely, brother. You don't know what say? Today, Stephanie called me. And she tell me, say, yo, our sister get robbed. In idea, because apparently our sister used a mechanic there at the bottom of Lindhurst Road. I must say Lindhurst Road? I don't know, Lindhurst Road, right, top side, the bottom part of Lindhurst Road, top side jungle, so. You see me? Anyway, she left him with the car if he do something. And him say it's gonna take longer than when he think. So she has said to herself she don't want him keep her cash. She tell him to come link her at her workplace because she live work on retirement road. And she will drop him back
TJB.
and her next time when she have the time can left the vehicle. She do that. So she says, so boom and she drive she him a carry her back in garage. Him a drive her car. She in a passenger seat. She said them a driver go towards Linders Road and him. She said when she drive, she know she pass two youth on a bicycle. But she said she not pay them no mind. You see me? Anyway, boom bang, she reach at the garage, you know, and hold on. She reach at the garage, you know, and the man jump out of the van, cause she drive one of the new prior of them. Man jump out of the van and she come round for going in a passenger seat. She said by the time she reach at the door for open the door, the two boy that she see right pan her, she said she never know when them reach right round pan her from fear side, you see me? So she says she's so nervous because when she look on them, the one that is slump on the back, must say a bike when I yang them or something. She said, well, I'm slump on the back, lift up his shirt and show her the gun and him use the gun and slap him chest like him just knock it against him chest and the one where I ride, take out the gun and have the gun in him hand and I knock it with the one, him other hand. So she says she look on them and them I look on she because she says she in a shock. She don't know what to do, you see me? Same time, the one where ride, said to her, I say, yo, I go on, mommy. Everything all right? So she say, yeah, everything all right. You know, say, I look where I look at things still. So she said to them, say, look at things for what? She said, him, I say, one I'm bridging drop out and him, I look at things for have a little drink up. You don't know if you don't know him drop out and you don't know what, you know, kind of like a memorial type of thing. So she said, how much money say you want? The man said, himself $1,500, 15 bills. She said, she just, because her three, picnic them got ill. And she said, she just draw some money for pay one of them school fees. So she said, she no want. Go in at the car and go in at the bag for them follow her in at the car. So she said, to them, say, yo, I don't really have no money still, you know. But me can probably find a grand for gear. So him say, all right. But this are the blood clot tricky part now, brother. You know what I say? When she give the man the grand, you know where the man asks her? The man asks her if she not on a body where she want dash way. If she not on a body where who are in the money or this are and she just can't deal with it no more. She just willing to pay her money. Cause that them do. And if she not on a body at workplace where I give her a hard time, or in the body where I go on like them one box bread out her mouth. You see me? She said, no, I just start work, which part I'm working, you know, so I don't really know nobody. She said, him, I said, yeah. So, you know, nobody, no family, nobody where you want to get rid of nothing. She said, no, me, everybody good. So, I said, all right, mommy, me like you, you know, I like your vibes, you know, mommy. So, yeah, what? Me, I give you my number, and if anybody you want to deal with that, anything you want me to deal with, just shout me. I'm here to work out something, I'm going to deal with it for you, you see me? So, she said, all right, then. And she said, them there, I chat a little bit until him does jump on the bike and drive off. The two of them strap. But me, I said to Bumbleclats, I saw them man, you're willing. If you just take people life, yeah, ride down upon people with gun for $1,000, $1,500. And I saw them are willing for solicit service, for do assassin work, brother, or hitman work.
TJB.
In a broad daylight. This a man here, I look for rob the woman and him see him when I give him number for she call him. You see them people here nonsense. My youth, me I tell you this man from this man in a dark, so our country in a trouble in a better because at the level of violence and the level of a crime that has become embedded in our culture, brother. Me I tell you in a my youth. Me I tell you that. Me say she tell me, I couldn't believe. Me I say, really? She said, Marlani, if the police even they come to me and ask me what them look like, she said she couldn't tell them. Because she said, she's so frightened, she's so in a shock. She attack and she didn't even penetrate what she has said. You see me, I say? But me just show you them young youth, you might, and that's why police don't ram for dash them, my brother. And that's why them friend them don't ram for dash them, too. Because the man them not a sense, brother. The man them not a brain. The man them not a click. And one thing alone them a click for. Them don't want to work, them don't want to do nothing else. Them just want to rob people and take people things. I tell you, brother, it's sad.
TJB.
It's sad. Big man thing. It's sad.
Now, people, first thing first. Badness. Gunman. Hitman. It does not pay. It does not make any sort of sense to gain the world, lose your soul, lose your freedom, lose your life. Because whenever you choose that career path, it is a step to self-destruction. The possibility or probability of you being successful or even being alive past 30 is basically 0 to minus infinity, point blank and period. So people, I say this to say that if you are doing something, if you are taking risk, a whole lot of risk, jeopardizing your life, jeopardizing your freedom, and at the end of the day, you are not getting paid. So in other words, if it don't make any sorts of money, it does not make any sorts of sense. Next thing, if you are broke and you don't get up in the morning and seek some sort of employment, you don't have any sorts of goals and ambition, you get up 12 o'clock after the sun come up, after the sun basically in the sky for at least 3-4 hours, and you get up and you roll up a spliff and you wash off the bleaching cream off of your face. And people, I am not saying that everybody that bleach are criminal, me just say it is a story. And then you go up on the corner and you talk all sorts of ish. There is nothing progressive in that, because people, I've been on my own since I was 17, and people, this is my thing and the whole thing about survival in a life. If you don't have nothing, you need to get something. You need to make sure that you put yourself in a position, because people like them say, sometimes you have to basically kick down opportunity's door. You have to ask somebody that you see is progressive if you can do some sort of work with them, if them can hire you as a sideman, because people, when you are the sidekick of any sort of gangster, you are going to end up in the same place where he ends up or they end up. And people, you know exactly where that is. Now in this case, it shows you how stupid these shutters, thief, gunmen are, because people, they are looking at a victim driving this car and they are planning to rob her. However, it turned around after the lady gave them $1,000, or they asked for some money, and she says she have about $1,000 and she gave to them. They turn around and they are asking her. They now start to solicit business. They now start to put all sorts of business proposal, asking this lady if she have anybody that she wants to get rid of, if she have anybody that is bothering her, anybody that is a hindrance in her sight. So people, me just show you how foolish them is. Suppose this lady was a pauper. Suppose this lady was working with some sort of law enforcement and set up some sort of sting. They would have reached their destination faster. Me I talk about the big yard, or me I talk about the afterlife. So people, at the end of the day, this lady gave two gunmen $1,000. Now people, if my math suits me correctly, $1,000 between two persons, we are talking about $500. We are talking about $3. And people, may I talk about not even two boxwood, because I think that boxwood is about $700 a piece. So we are talking about $1,400. So people, we are talking about a boxwood and a half. So people, at the end of the day, this is my suggestion. Whenever you are doing any sorts of business in the garrison, be very careful about the places that you go. Be very careful that this place is run under some sort of order. And people, even when it is run under some sort of order, you always have some rogue thief that are always going to get out of line and do all sorts of BS. So people, me just say, be very careful out there. And most importantly, I am warning these young men out there in Jamaica, these youth that have aspirations of being criminal people, you are going to be DEADING. Very soon. If 2020 pass and you're not gone, 2022 now gonna pass you. Point blank and period. So anyways, people, that is my views on the whole thing as it pertains to that. And like me say, it is just my views and opinion. It is not the gospel. Your views and opinion can be respectfully different from mine. But let me know what you think in the comment section. Bless up.